Hey guys, this is Mrs. Howard and welcome to DMS Flipped Math. Today we're learning about percent proportions. A percent proportion can be used to find a missing part, whole, or percent. This table should look a little familiar because we've used our tic-tac-toes and our word ratios to set up proportions before. The percent proportion is no different. There are two main parts, our part and our whole. Okay? The part and whole will be depending on the problem, whether that's part of the price of something or part of our class, but percent is always the same. Our percent is always the part, and we know that all percents are out of 100, and so the percent whole will always be 100. We can use vertical number lines to estimate the answer and set up our percent proportion. With the vertical number lines, we have two number lines. One represents whatever we're talking about in that problem. So if that's money or the number of students in a class, and then we've got our percent number line, which will always be our percent that is out of 100. And we'll kind of benchmark these number lines to determine or estimate where our answer should be to a problem. So here's our first example. What number is 80% of 500? Our part and whole are already set up, and we can use some simple words, is and of, to help us figure out where these numbers go in our percent proportion. So first I notice what number is. Okay? What number means I don't know what number is, and I'm going to put my variable there. Okay? 80%, we know percent is always out of 100. And so my 80 is going to be placed over 100. Lastly, of 500. So that has to be my whole number, is over of, and so my 500 is going in the whole. Now, before I work this out, I'll use my vertical number lines to estimate where my answer should be. So my whole is 500, which is going to be down here with the whole percent. 100%. Okay? I'm estimating for 80%. Well, let me kind of benchmark it first. Well, I know half is going to be 50%, so I'm going to just put a bar there. Okay? And if I kind of just use some common knowledge, half of 500 is 250. Okay? If I'm looking to go 80%, I could even put me a benchmark halfway between 50 and 100. So 75%, okay? And then know that 75% is gonna be halfway between 250 and 500. So 375. All right, and so then when I go to find 80% of 500, my 80% should fall not too far ahead of 75%. And so I know that my n, or my missing number, is going to be just a little bit more than 375, okay? The percent proportion and our number lines have set up our problem for us. So my problem's already set up. From here, I just need to cross multiply and divide, okay? So I've got 100 times n is equal to 500 times 80. And we know that we can set up this equation because our cross products have to be equal in a proportion. So 500 times 80 is 40,000. And we're going to divide that by 100. Okay. 100 divided by 100, of course, is now just n here. And 40,000 divided by 100 gives us an answer of 400. When we go back and evaluate our vertical number lines, 400, just a little bit more than 375, and so that's a reasonable answer. All right, try number two on your own. If your answer was incorrect, refer back to the first example. The problems are exactly the same, but just a few different numbers, okay? Let's move on to example number three. A lot of times our problems are easy when we just got the numbers, but we've got to do a little bit more evaluating when we've got our word problems. So number three reads, how many milliliters of HCl, hydrochloric acid, is in a 60 milliliter bottle that is marked 75% HCl? So before I even start, I know that I'm looking for a percent. I'm going to go ahead and fill in my whole 100%. How many milliliters of HCl in a 60 milliliter bottle? In a 60 milliliter bottle. That tells me that the whole bottle is 60 milliliters. So I'm going to go ahead and fill in 60 for my whole. And since I don't know how many milliliters are in that that part, I'm going to use my N there. Okay. My bottle is marked 75% HCl. I know that my percent has to be out of 100. Okay. So now let's estimate where our answer should be. Our whole 60, which is here at the bottom next to our 100%. Okay. I'm going to go ahead again and use the benchmark of 50%, so halfway. And I know that half of 60 is 30. Okay? And so now I'm looking for 75%. So I know that my answer should be halfway between 60 and 30. So now let's work that problem out and get our answer and make sure that it's reasonable. So our percent proportion is already set up using the table and using the vertical number lines. We know that from here, we're going to cross multiply and divide by 100. So first we've got 60 times 75. All right, we're going to work that part out. 450. And then 450 divided by 100. Our N, or our missing part, is equal to 45. And we're talking about milliliters of HCl here. So I'm going to put 45 milliliters. If we look to see if that's reasonable, well, I'm pretty sure that 45 is halfway between 30 and 60. All right, go ahead and try the next example on your own. All right, guys, here's our last example. During the last 4 years, Julius has visited 26% of the 50 states in the U.S. How many states did he visit during the last 4 years? So let's break apart the problem, put together our percent proportion. Julius has visited 26%. We know percent is always out of 100. He's visited 26% of the 50 states. We know that there are 50 states in the United States, and that should be our whole, but we also know that trick is over of, and since of the 50 states, we can match that up with our whole, okay? We want to know how many states did he visit. So we know the percent that he visited, but we don't know the actual number of states. All right, we use our percent benchmarks to estimate our answer. 100% would be the 50 states. Halfway, 50% would be 25 states. We can benchmark it one more and go halfway between 50 and 0, and we know 25% would be 12 and a half states, which isn't really realistic. But we know that we're looking for 26%, which would be just a little bit more than 25, and so that our answer should be a little bit more than 12 and a half. When you go to work your percent proportion, cross multiply and divide, 50 times 26 gives us 1,300. And then we're going to divide by 100 to get that Julius has visited 13 states. All right, guys, I hope we have an understanding of percent proportions. If there are any issues within your notes, feel free to rewind, fast forward, pause, take a little bit of extra time and look through those examples and see if there's anything you may need some extra help on. Also, there is a mistake in the video. Find that mistake and see what you'll get in class tomorrow. See you guys.